Good afternoon. Thank you very much for joining us for this fifth session of Parliament. It is the National Assembly on this 24th day of January 2017. I do welcome you to this live broadcast. You are looking at live pictures from the floor of the National Assembly. My name is Edward Kabasa. This is a broadcast brought to you by the Parliamentary Broadcasting Unit in conjunction with the Kenya Broadcasting Corporation. It is a broadcast available on Bunge TV as well as KBC Channel 1. This afternoon, there will be a motion on approval of the House Business Committee, and this is courtesy of House Standing Order 171. It says there shall be a select committee to be designated the House Business Committee, which will consist of the Speaker, who shall be the Chairperson, the Leader of the Majority Party, the Leader of the Minority Party, and not less than 21 and not more than 29 members, who shall be nominated by parliamentary parties and approved by the House at the commencement of every session, reflecting the relative majorities of the seats held by each of the parliamentary parties in the National Assembly, and taking into consideration the interests of independence. The House Business Committee shall be appointed within 7 days on assembly of a new House. And in nominating the members to the House Business Committee, each parliamentary party shall include its whip into the membership. In the absence of the Speaker, the Deputy Speaker shall attend and chair the meetings of the House Business Committee. And basically, the House Business Committee shall prepare and, if necessary, from time to time, adjust the parliamentary calendar with the approval of the House, and also monitor and oversee the implementation of the House business and programs. As well, that committee shall implement the standing orders respecting the scheduling or programming of the business of the House and the functioning of the committees of the House. As well, it shall determine the order in which the reports of committees shall be debated in the House. The House Business Committee as well may take decisions and issue directives and guidelines to prioritize or postpone any business of the House, acting with the concurrence of the leader of the majority party or the leader of the minority party, as the case may be. So there are a number of members of parliament whose names have been proposed here, and among them the Honorable Kato Olemitito, the Honorable Jakoya Midiwo, the Honorable Dr. Naomi Shaban, the Honorable Thomas Modego. If you're just joining us, these are live pictures from the floor of the National Assembly. The Speaker of the National Assembly, the Honorable Justin Muturi, is currently walking into the chamber. So I will hand you over so that you can follow these proceedings live.
Ewe Mwenyezi Mungu, ambaye kwa hekima na wema wako umeteua nyadhifa za viongozi na mabunge kwa ustawi wa jamii na utawala wa haki wa wanadamu. Twakusihi ututazame kwa neema nyingi sisi watumishi wako ambao umerithika kutuita ili tutekeleze shughuli muhimu za jamhuri yetu. Twakuomba ututeremshie baraka zako sisi tuliokutanika hapa, na utujalie tuyatende na kuyafikiria mambo yote yatakayofikishwa mbele yetu kwa njia ya haki na uaminifu, ili utukufu na sifa zako ziendelezwe, na ili kustawisha amani, ufanisi na heri ya nchi yetu, na wale ambao haja zao wamezikabidhi mikononi mwetu. Amen. Well, I confirm that we don't have quorum and direct that the division bell be rung for initial 10 minutes.
If you are just tuning in, the House has lacked quorum, and so the Speaker has ordered the quorum bell be rung, and that is courtesy of Standing Order Number 34, which says that a quorum of the House or of a committee of the whole House shall be 50 members. If there is not a quorum present when the chair is taken at the time appointed for a meeting of the House, immediately after the saying of the prayer, the Speaker shall order the bell to be rung for 10 minutes. And if no quorum is present at the expiration of the 10 minutes, the Speaker may direct that the bell be rung for a further 5 minutes. And if there's still no quorum present, the Speaker shall adjourn the House forthwith to the next sitting. As it stands, there is no quorum, and that quorum bell is being rung. The approval of the House Business Committee, that is one of the businesses that this House will be looking into this afternoon. And basically, one of the functions of this committee is to consider such matters as may from time to time arise in connection with the business of the House, and shall have and perform such powers and functions as are conferred on and ascribed to it by the standing orders of the National Assembly, or from time to time by the this House, the National Assembly. The chairperson and at least one third of the other members of the House Business Committee shall form a quorum. This committee is made up of 29 members, that is minus the Speaker, the Majority Party Leader, and the Minority Party Leader. The Honorable Katole Mititu has been proposed as a member of the House Business Committee. The quorum has been achieved, so I will hand you over so that you can follow these proceedings live on Bunga TV and on KBC Channel 1.
The chair. Order members, this communication number 001 of 2017 relates to the election of members to the 4th East African Legislative Assembly, commonly known as IALA. Honourable members, this being my first communication this year, I take the opportunity to welcome all of you back to the House for the 5th and ultimately the final session of the 11th Parliament. I do hope, honourable members, that you have invigorated sufficiently to be able to consider and conclude the pending business for the remainder of the term. Having said so, I now wish to convey the following message relating to election of members to serve during the 4th term of the East African Legislative Assembly. Honourable members, pursuant to the provisions of Section 3 of the East African Legislative Assembly Elections Act 2011, I have received a notification from the clerk of the East African Legislative Assembly, IALA, regarding the expiry of the term of the current third East African Legislative Assembly, which will come to an end on the fourth day of June 2017. The notification requests that the Parliament of Kenya causes the election of members to represent the country in the Assembly. Honourable members, the East African Legislative Assembly is established under Article 9 of the Treaty for the Establishment of the East African Community, EAC, as one of the key organs and institutions of the community. Articles 50 and 51 of the EAC Treaty provides for election of members of the Assembly and the tenure of the office of elected members, respectively. Specifically, Article 51, Subsection 1, provides that an elected member of the Assembly shall hold office for 5 years and be eligible for re-election for a further term of 5 years. The current Assembly was elected in 2012. Additionally, Section 4, Subsections 1 and 2 of the East African Legislative Assembly Elections Act 2011 provides that the election of members to the Assembly shall be conducted in accordance with the rules of procedure of the legislatures of the partner states. The Act also requires that the elections ought to be conducted within 90 days before the expiry of the date of the outgoing Assembly. The effective date in this case is March 4, 2017. Honorable members, it is my view that the current elections rules, which were adopted by the National Assembly of Kenya in April 2011 and published in the Kenya Gazette through Legal Notice Number 31 of 11th of May 2012, require a review to conform to the bicameral nature of our parliament. In this regard, a team of officers of the Houses of Parliament has been constituted to propose amendments to the existing rules for election of members to the Assembly, taking into account the bicameral nature of our parliament and the relative political party majorities. The text of the proposed amendments will be submitted to the two Houses of Parliament for consideration soonest. The rules, once adopted by the Parliament, will thereafter inform the next course of action, including the process of nomination of candidates and election procedure. In view of the foregoing, leadership of political parties in the House are notified of the process and advised to await direction from the Houses on the rules to be applied upon adoption. I thank you, honourable members.
Order number 3, messages. Order number 4, petitions. Order number 5, papers.
Honorable Kato.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I beg to lay the following papers on the table of the House today, Tuesday, January 24th, 2017. One, the National Treasury Annual Public Debt Management Report for the year 2015-2016. Two, the Office of the Auditor General Special Audit on the University of Nairobi Financial Procurement and Human Resources Management, January 2017. Three, the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission third quarterly report covering July 1st, 2016 to September 30th, 2016. Fourth, the National Government Constituency Development Fund Board report on project approvals and disbursement status, December 2016, including restrictions on constituency accounts. Fifth, the Public Service Commission evaluation report on public service compliance with the value and principles in Articles 10 and 232 of the Constitution for the year 2015-2016. Six, the National Authority for Campaign Against Alcohol and Drug Abuse, NACADA. Seventh, biannual progress report of the Alcohol and Drug Abuse Control in Kenya, October 2015 to March 2016. Seventh, the annual report and financial statement in respect of the following institution for the year ended 2014-2015. That is Laikipia University, Kenya Ports Authority, and the University of Nairobi, And number 8, the annual reports and financial statement of Kenya Post Office Savings Bank for the year ended 31st December 2014. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Well, the National Treasury Annual Public Debt Management Report for the year 2015-2016 is accordingly referred to the Departmental Committee on Finance, Planning and Trade. The others will be referred to the relevant committees. Next.
Order number 6, notices of motion. Order number 7, statements. Order number 8, approval of the House Business Committee. Motion.
Honorable Kato.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, may I also first take this opportunity to really wish the members a happy new year of 2017, and also, as you have clearly said it, wish them well in fight and wish them well in this last lap of the 11th Parliament. And therefore, Mr. Speaker, having said that, I wish to move the motion that pursuant to the provision of Standing Order number 171, subparagraph 1D, this House approves the appointment of the following members to the House Business Committee, in addition to the members specified under paragraph A, B, and C. And Mr. Speaker, for the avoidance of doubt, the members specified are the Speaker, who is the Chairperson, the Leader of Majority, and the Leader of Minority in the House. And in addition to the following one, the Honorable Kato Lemetito, the Honorable Jakoe Midio, the Honorable Dr. Naomi Shaban, the Honorable Thomas Madegu, the Honorable Jamle Kamau, the Honorable William Cheptumo, the Honorable Engineer M.M. Mahamud, the Honorable David Were, the Honorable Z.K. Cheriot, the Honorable Mithika Linturi, the Honorable Jessica Mbalu, the Honorable Dr. Victor Munyaka, the Honorable John Serut, the Honorable Wafula Wamunyinyi, the Honorable Cecilia Ngetich, the Honorable Priscilla Nyokavi, the Honorable Dr. Rachel Nyamai, the Honorable Peter Shea, the Honorable Joyce Amani Kakai, the Honorable Johnson Sakaja, the Honorable Dr. Makali Mulu, the Honorable Danita Gati, the Honorable Gladys Wanga, the Honorable Florence Kajuju, the Honorable Dr. Susan Munyaka Musioka, the Honorable K.K. Stephen Mboro Kinyanjui, the Honorable Missy Juma, the Honorable Francis Chachu Ganya, the Honorable Christopher Wamalo. Mr. Speaker, I just wish to inform the House that as you clearly see on the order paper, this is the only business in today's session or sitting. And Mr. Speaker, it's because the rule and the procedure of the House states that in the first sitting of the first session of the House, the only business to be transacted is the formation of the House Business Committee. And Mr. Speaker, it is after the House has approved this committee that this committee goes sit immediately under your chairmanship, that they form the business of the House now beginning tomorrow. I'm sure the first agenda they will have to tackle is the calendar of the House, and then thereafter list the business of the House as beginning tomorrow morning, Mr. Speaker. And therefore, Mr. Speaker, the names have not changed. It is the old House Business Committee, because we are just left with about 29 weeks to come to the end of the life of this Parliament, Mr. Speaker. And therefore, we saw it necessary as the House leadership, Mr. Speaker, that we for continuity purposes, we allow these members to finish the business of this 11th Parliament, Mr. Speaker. And therefore, I urge the House that they approve these names. Then they move immediately to come up with the business of the House for the House to start transacting business. With those few remarks, Mr. Speaker, I beg to move and ask my colleague, Honorable Thomas Madengu, to second.
Honorable Madengu.
Asante, Mheshimiwa Speaker. Naomba nichukue nafasi hii kuunga mkono hoja hii, na nikiwa naiunga hoja hii mkono, Mheshimiwa Speaker, naomba nami nitumie nafasi hii vile vile kuwatakia wabunge wenzangu kila laheri wakati wa muhula huu ambao utakuwa ni muhula ambao watakuwa wanakunja jamvi wakijiandaa kwa uchaguzi ambao utakuwako hapo mwakani. Mheshimiwa Speaker, tunakubaliana kuwa bunge limejaribu kufanya lile ambalo lingeweza kufanya, na zile kazi ambazo zimebaki na imani wabunge watajitolea kikamilifu kuhakikisha kuwa wamefuata ratiba yao ambayo tunaenda kuizungumzia leo jioni, ili wakapate kukamilisha zile kazi ambazo wamepatiwa na wananchi wazifanye. Mheshimiwa Speaker, vile ilivyosemwa na mwenzangu, uongozi wa bunge umeonelea haina haja ya kubadilisha viongozi ambao wako wanahudumu katika kamati hii ambayo inashirikia masuala ya bunge. Tumeamua Mheshimiwa Speaker tuiache vile vile ili ipate kuwajibika ikamalize huu muhula, ili tupate kuendelea na kazi ambazo tumepatiwa za bunge. Mheshimiwa Speaker, naomba vile vile chukua wakati huu niulize ama niombe wabunge wenzangu kuwa tujibidishe tuwezavyo ili tukapate kujumuika na wenzetu wakati huu ambao kwa kujiandikisha, ili wakati utakapofika Mheshimiwa Speaker wa kupiga kura mwezi wa August, tuwe kila mtu amejiandaa vilivyo ili kuhakikisha kuwa wamerudi. Lakini naomba pia nitoe tahadhari Mheshimiwa Speaker, kulingana na tarakimu vile zile tulizonazo Mheshimiwa Speaker, theluthi nane, theluthi 80 ya wabunge huwa kawaida hawarudi. Kwa hivyo hapa huenda ikawa kuna wengine ambao watakuwa nakunja jamvi lao kabisa la kuondoka bungeni, muda umekuwa umeyoma umeisha. Kwa hivyo ni muhimu Mheshimiwa Speaker wabunge wajiandae kwa vyovyote ambavyo vitakuwa vinatokea. Wengine wetu kama sisi Mheshimiwa Speaker tushaamua kuwa bungeni hatutaki kurudi, maana na nitaomba kiti ya ugavana. Kwa hivyo wenzangu, tunaagana polepole na nawatakia kila laheri katika kazi hii ambayo mtakuwa mnaifanya, ili angalau tuweze kujumuisha nchi yetu vile ilivyo. Mheshimiwa Speaker, naweka tamati. Nasema Mheshimiwa Speaker kuwa kulingana na tarakimu tulizonazo bungeni, theluthi 80 ya wabunge kawaida hawarudi. Kwa hivyo wengine watakuwa wanakunja jamvi lao wakiwa wanaondoka, wanaaga bunge. Mimi nikiwa ni mmoja wa bunge ambao wakati huu nami nitakuwa nakunja jamvi langu kama mbunge wa Bundanyi, maana nitakuwa naomba kiti ya ugavana katika kaunti ya Taita Taveta. Kwa hivyo nami wenzangu nawaaga polepole wakati huu ambao nitakuwa nimewatumikia. Kwa hivyo kwa muktasari Mheshimiwa Speaker, nawatakia wabunge kila laheri kwa kazi yao, na naomba tafadhali wabunge, na kwa heshima na tazma kubwa, muunge majina haya mkono ili tupate kuendelea na kazi. Kwa haya machache na mengi Mheshimiwa Speaker, naomba kuunga mkono majina haya ili yakapate kuratibiwa na bunge na tuendelee na kazi. Asante Mheshimiwa Speaker.
Other members, I know it was 1 month, so Engineer Mahmoud might have forgotten that when a motion has been moved, it has to be proposed. He's doing what? Is he among those ones, Honorable Mwadegu is saying goodbye? Nevertheless, Honorable Members, I propose the question that pursuant to the provisions of Standing Order Number 171, Clause 1, Paragraph D, this House approves the appointment of the following members to the House Business Committee, in addition to the members specified under paragraphs A, B, and C. 1, the Honorable Kato Olemetito. 2, the Honorable Jacob Midiwo. 3, the Honorable Dr. Naomi Shaban. 4, the Honorable Thomas Mwadegu himself. 5, the Honorable Jamle Kamau. 6, the Honorable William Cheptumo. 7, the Honorable Engineer M.M. Mahmoud. 8, the Honorable David Were. 9, the Honorable Z.K. Cheruyot. 10, the Honorable Mithika Linturi. 11, the Honorable Jessica Mbalu. 12, the Honorable Dr. Victor Munyaka. 13, the Honorable John Serut. 14, the Honorable Wafula Wamunyinyi. 15, the Honorable Cecilia Ngetich. 16, the Honorable Priscilla Nyokabi. 17, the Honorable Dr. Rachel Nyamai. 18, the Honorable Peter Shehe. 19, the Honorable Joyce Emanico Akai. 20, the Honorable Johnson Sakaja. 21, the Honorable Makali Mulu, Dr. Makali Mulu. 22, the Honorable Danita Gati. 23, the Honorable Gladys Wanga. 24, the Honorable Florence Kajuju. 25, the Honorable Dr. Susan Musioka. 26, the Honorable K.K. Stephen Kinyanjui Mburu. 27, the Honorable Mishi Juma. 28, the Honorable Francis Chachuganya. And 29, the Honorable Chrysanthus Wamalwa. Now, members, I've seen a number of you who have put requests. Is it an indication that you want to contribute to this crucial motion? Well, the first one on the list, because there should be no order here, is the Honorable Member for, not the Member for Kibra. I hope you are not in the category that the Honorable Mwendegu spoke about. Honorable Ken Okoth. You put your card at your normal place of abode. Just look up, look behind. This machine only recognizes you there.
Anzo's neighborhood.
Then you can speak from there.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise and say I'm delighted to support the motion. We are in the last session, and many of these members have served there with distinction. I know it is campaign season, and it's also the month where many of the members are working hard to register voters and to meet the targets as we prepare for August 8th. But I know they'll have to find a way to balance the important duties of this House and other competing commitments outside there. So I think it's a great thing. I see on this list a special member that I serve with on the Education Committee, Cecilia Ngetich, who is listed, but as number 15 there. Cecilia Ngetich serves with me on the Education Committee, and I wanted to celebrate her because last year she passed a bill on engineers and technicians bill, and that has helped to streamline that sector and in a very impactful way, and she was recently recognized also by the Technical University of Kenya with an honorary doctorate. So I think that's great news to celebrate from a colleague that I've worked closely with and who shares an office next to me, and they'll continue their good work. I also know, as we get to run around myself, I've also been trying to do good work. My constituency was ranked number 2 out of 290 in CDF usage. I celebrate my CDF committee, and I ask that the CDF committee in this House please assist the members in this House with a supplementary budget so we can do the projects, especially the 10 billion that needs to come to our educational institution to build those schools, to build those classrooms, to build those dormitories. CDF is a lifeline for members of parliament, whether they'll be here or not. I think they want to leave a legacy and do good work for their people. So I hope that this committee will do well and will look into it and prioritize the issue of a supplementary budget with monies for CDF to come up as business to this House so that we can ratify it quickly and make a difference. With those few remarks, I pray for all members of this House that they may be safe and have good health as they go on with their work and campaigns, and that we'll finish the 11th Parliament on a high note with a record number of good bills passed for the benefit of our people. I support Mr. Speaker. Thank you.
And now that Honorable Ken Okoth has raised that issue of the supplementary budget, I think it's fair to also appreciate that the supplementaries were tabled on one of the days that we had a special sitting. And it's only fair that other departmental committees immediately prioritize the consideration of supplementary budgets with a view to having them considered by the House in the course of next week. Cyprian Iringo.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for giving me this opportunity to support this motion. of the approval of the House Business Committee. Mr. Speaker, first and foremost, let me thank the Almighty God for having brought us this far and this here, all of us safely, and thank all the members who have come back to start this final lap. And I believe it will be a lap of honor whereby we are going to do our best to finalize what really is supposed to have been done by us, despite that we are not going to live to the 5 years, the period which has been shortened by the Constitution. Mr. Speaker, I think we shall go down in history as having done most of the work which was put in front of us, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I support that the idea that these members should continue, because at least we have a short period to go. They have done a good job before under your leadership, Mr. Speaker, and I see no doubt that you are going to continue with the same team in the same spirit for the benefit of this country and the purpose of putting in order all the provisions which were yet to be done in this 11th Parliament to put our constitution into actualization. Mr. Speaker, all members are craving to go back down there for campaigns. I think everybody is geared to the same, but all you know, Mr. Speaker, still the House has to sit because the constitution allows that we continue sitting. So I urge my colleagues, despite the tight schedules outside there, let us also endeavor to give quorum so that at least the businesses of the House are not stalled, and at least we can see ourselves moving. It will be tedious and tricky, but Mr. Speaker, I know we shall make it. Finally, Mr. Speaker, let me add my voice on the supplementary budget, and especially on the CNDF, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, we remember that there's an amount which was slashed by the courts, but something was done about it, and we feel the schools which were supposed to benefit from this kit, Mr. Speaker, especially the secondary schools, they are already suffering, Mr. Speaker, because we were yet to put some classrooms in those areas, and they have already received the form ones and evidence. Some of my principals are calling me, telling me they have nowhere to house these new students, Mr. Speaker, especially as far as classrooms are concerned. Therefore, let us expedite this one so that this money can be released as fast as possible, because there are children outside there who don't have anywhere to sit as we talk. And the faster we do this one, it will be better for our children. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I support.
Andrew Mwandime, member for Mwatate.
Oh, asante sana, Mheshimiwa Speaker.
You have forgotten that you have placed a request.
Shukrani kwa kunipa hii nafasi. Mwanzo kabisa, naunga mkono hii hoja. Manake, wote nikiwaangalia, wana uzoefu na hii kazi. Lakini kabla sijaendelea, Mheshimiwa Speaker, ningependelea kuwapa wenzangu mwaka wenye fanaka, na vile vile kwa zile shughuli nyingi wako nazo mbeleni, naomba pia wafanikiwe. Mheshimiwa Speaker, vile vile najua Kenya wote sahi wamejitokezea kujiandikisha kwa kura, ningeomba watoke kwa wingi. Vile vile IEBC jaribu kuangalia pale kuna utata, kama vile jana niliona mmoja wa eneo bunge langu alikuwa anajaribu kadi za watu wake ambao walikuwa wamefariki, akizijaribu ikaonekana bado kura zao zipo.
Honorable members, the consultations are too loud. I know there is excitement about the
asante sana Mheshimiwa Speaker.
But be relevant to the motion, please.
Yeah, asante sana Mheshimiwa Speaker kwa uongozi wako. Lakini vile nimesema, hao wote ninaunga mkono kwa sababu wana uzoefu wa hii kazi na wanaendelea na kazi, na ule mde mfupi ambao umebakia kwa bunge ni heri wamalizie. Lakini Mheshimiwa Speaker, vile vile ni vyema, manake mwaka huu ni mwaka wa mambo mengi. Na kwa sababu ni mwaka ambao una mambo mengi, ndio ningeomba IBC ijaribu kuangalia pale kuna tatizo kidogo, wajaribu kutafuta suluhu, kama vile jana tulikuwa tunajaribu na moja wa eneo bunge langu vitambulisho ambavyo ni watu wa wake ambao walikuwa wamefariki akizijaribu kuziweka katika zile machine na bado inakaa kama kura zao bado zipo. Ni vyema IBC waungane na watu wa vitambulisho wakati mtu amepatwa na maafa angalau lile jina liondolewe. Mheshimiwa Speaker, asante sana kwa kunipa hii fursa.
Johnson Sakaja.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise to support this motion in as much as I am listed as one of the members of the House Business Committee. I'd also like to take this opportunity, Mr. Speaker, to wish members a happy new year. Mr. Speaker, as you can see from the numbers, it was indeed a task even today to get the full quorum because members are fully focused on the coming election. But I am confident, Mr. Speaker, that even as we proceed with the business of the House and the business of elections, members will be able to dedicate their time for the important business that we still have of representation and legislation. Mr. Speaker, I am aware that we will need to prioritize a number of things, Mr. Speaker, such as the budget process. We need to see how to fast track it and other pieces of legislation. And Mr. Speaker, I'd like to take this opportunity. I don't know if you can hear me, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I know members have missed each other, but if they can lower the tone of their discussions. I want to confirm that I am one of those Mheshimiwa Mwandegu is talking about, so this is my last session in this House. There are two categories. There are those who will not come on purpose. Those are those who are going for other positions. Like me, I'm going for governor and other people. But the others will not come not out of their own will, but by the will of the people. And so I would like to wish all of them all the best, whether you don't come because you've won elsewhere or whether you don't come because the people don't appreciate the work you've been doing. Mr. Speaker, I also want to just echo the remarks of Honorable Ken Okoth, and I would like to just take this opportunity to congratulate Honorable Ken Okoth of Kibra, together with Honorable Osele, Honorable George Theuri, and Honorable Stephen Kariuki. Those are four members out of the top five best performing CDF in the CDF in the last year. And it's important to note, Mr. Speaker, that all of those members, four out of five of those who performed the best in CDF, are members of my Kenya Young Parliamentarians Association. They are all members who, at the time of election, were youthful members. So I would like to congratulate them, and I hope it's a reflection of our leadership as young people. And we hope that in the next election, Kenyans will be able to vote in many more of such vibrant young legislators. And number one in central, of course, was Wakape, my good friend. Mr. Speaker, as I finish, I just like to urge members that even as we go towards the election, let us remember the principles and tenets that hold our democracy together. Let us not raise political tensions, as you have been seeing across the country. We know it is a time of many realignments. People are free to move wherever they want to. But let us remember that at the end of the day, we have one country. You will either win your election or lose it. It is not a matter of life and death. But we just want to urge our brother Ken, we saw what is happening in your constituency. You're welcome to Jubilee. We will give you a ticket. We know it might be tough, but we know the will of the people will always be stronger than any anointed leader. So we wish you all the best, my brother. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and asante.
Member for Ugunja.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I wish to join my colleagues in supporting this motion. Mr. Speaker, this is one such motion that comes only once per session. And this is the last time this motion is being debated in the life of this 11th Parliament. Mr. Speaker, the reason why I want to support this motion is because of the need for continuity. The members who have served in this important committee of the House have done well by all standards. And therefore, I commend the leadership of the House for having found it fit to retain them. They have done fairly well. And I wish to congratulate them for the good job they have done in this committee. Mr. Speaker, this is a committee which is very important because it's a committee that sets the agenda for the House. And therefore, it is important that men and women who sit in it are people who have been tested and tried. And therefore, on that account, I am happy, extremely happy, that we have retained our old membership. Mr. Speaker, we are alive to the fact that this is the last session of the 11th Parliament. Mr. Speaker, we are also alive to the fact that one of the most urgent agenda for this session is the budget. Mr. Speaker, the budget this time round is so important because for the first time in our history, it's going to come fairly earlier than the rest of the times. Mr. Speaker, as we anticipate to address the matter of the budget so that the country can run, Mr. Speaker, we must point out the fact that this is the House that is entrusted with the sole responsibility of budget making. Mr. Speaker, the National Assembly is the only institution that the Constitution has given the mandate to make budget. But I must say, Mr. Speaker, that it is unfortunate that of late the executive through the Treasury has made attempts to usurp this very key role of the National Assembly. And why do I say so, Mr. Speaker? Mr. Speaker, we have seen instances in the past where budget estimates, proposals have come before various committees of the House, and those committees have made serious recommendations, Mr. Speaker, on the budget. Mr. Speaker, these recommendations have ended up being overruled, Mr. Speaker, by the executive, which has got no role whatsoever in determining the actual amounts that go to various departments or government. Mr. Speaker, to add salt to injury, there has been a circular which has been released lately from the Treasury, a circular which, in my view, goes against the letter and spirit of the Constitution, insofar as the budget-making process is concerned. Mr. Speaker, the Cabinet Secretary for Treasury has had the audacity to issue out a circular.
Honourable members, we need to hear what the member of Oguja is saying. And honourable members, those of you that have been named in this committee, I can see some of them walking out. Speaker, it is our rule that there must be quorum even in the committee. And soon after we finish this business, that committee will straight head to room 9 for a meeting to determine business commencing tomorrow morning. So we need to hear the member for Oguja and then make a decision about this one. Please, those of you who have been named in the committee, don't walk away.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I was raising a very pertinent issue. That this assembly, this National Assembly, is the only institution under the Constitution which has got a sole mandate to determine the budget. Mr. Speaker, it is unfortunate that the executive, through the Treasury, has attempted over time to usurp that very key mandate of the National Assembly. We are alive, we are aware that there is a circular which has been issued of late by the Cabinet Secretary for Treasury. A circular which, in essence, is making it impossible for the National Assembly to play its constitutional role of determining budgetary allocations. The Speaker, the Cabinet Secretary has purported to direct officers under him not to come before Parliament and seek Parliament's authority in determining allocations to various departments. The Speaker, that's an issue.
You know, there are certain things which are done, and if you ask the member for Kisumu Town West, the Honorable John Olago Aluoch, he will tell you the
people act per incurium, in ignorance of the law. Your own, I mean, the Constitution's own Article 125 gives Parliament, both in committee and in plenary, the power to summon any person for purposes of giving evidence or information to either the committee or the plenary.